Comes, we shall be like him, and praise God, we shall see him as he is. Now, some people say the Lord is dead. I affirm he's alive, yeah. And I believe one day we shall see Jesus, yeah, just as he is. Praise God. Thank you.
greatest story ever told, as Jesus not only the central character, but holds the message itself. His life here on earth and the story that was written in the Bible has been read from generation to generation. And unlike any other story, whether it is fiction or non-fiction, the story of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus is the only one that holds an eternal effect to mankind, the key to our salvation. Every story has its beginning. To fully comprehend the message of the greatest story, it is important to know and believe how it all started. It all began a long time ago in that silent and holy night. When the time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a virgin, born under law, to redeem those under the law.
Thank you.
took the form of a man. He set aside the privileges of deity and took on the status of a slave and to become human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Instead, he lived a selfless, obedient life and then died a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death of that, a crucifixion. It has been 2,000 years and the story still lives on. In the Old Testament was to be fulfilled. As prophesied by Isaiah, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, "Prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him." In those days, John the Baptist was preaching in the wilderness of Judea about repentance. Then Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John.
"Repent, for the kingdom of God is come near. Repent, all of you, and turn to God."
"I came here to be baptized."
"I need to be baptized by you, and you come to me?"
"Let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this, to fulfill all righteousness."
As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighted on him. And a voice from heaven said,
"This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased."
So then,
is Jesus? This was also the question that the Lord himself asked his disciples.
Who do people say I am?
Some say you're John the Baptist. Some say you're Elijah.
Some of you say you are Jeremiah or one of the prophets.
What about you, Simon? Who do you say I am?
You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God.
Blessed are you, Simon, son Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by flesh and blood, but by my Father in heaven.
Thank you. Disciple has come. Do you know who he is?
What do you want?
I heard your concern about Jesus.
Yes, we're concerned.
His teaching was blasphemous and is putting our own existence. Don't you know anyone who associates with this man is guilty as blasphemer?
So what are you willing to offer me if I handed him over to you?
So! Not all who those who follow him have blinded the truth.
If you're earnest, how much we will pay you?
30 pieces of silver.
30 pieces?
We agree.
How will you accomplish this?
Yes, and how would you deliver it to us?
I will come to you at the time of Passover. He will be with his disciples at that time. So ready you men. The man whom I kiss is the one you should seize.
Very good. Here's your son.
Jesus and his disciples became so popular with the people during this time. People had become interested in him and were amazed by the wonders that he had done. And everywhere they'd go, the crowds followed him. The chief priests and leaders of religion became so envious of Jesus, they made a plot to arrest and kill him. One of the 12 apostles, Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and made an arrangement so they can arrest Jesus. For 30 pieces of silver coins, Judas had betrayed the Lord. On the evening of the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, while Jesus and the 12 apostles were reclining at the table eating, he told them the truth that from among the apostles, one will betray him. The 12 apostles were saddened and began to say to him, one after the other, that they will not betray the Lord. But Jesus made it clear that the one who will betray him is one of them, the one who dips bread into the bowl with him.
You are blessed if you do. Truly I tell you today, one of you will betray me.
Who is it?
Lord, who is it? One who is eating. It is the one to whom I'm giving this bread after I have dipped it in the dish.
Is it I, Lord?
to you. Thank you. husband.
Yeah.
have examined him before you and found no basis for your charges against him, neither Herod. So he has sent him back to me, but I'll give him credit. As a custom to you, I will release one prisoner at this time of Passover. Do you want me to release the king of the Jews?
Oh!
Jesus. Jesus. Remember me when you come to your kingdom.
주님, God said that you will be with me in heaven.
Thank you. Right now, I would like to call on Sister C.G. Santa Maria to offer a song of praise.
Save a wretch like me.